Welcome to Intellipaat. Hey guys, hope you all are doing fine. This is Shubhra and today I'm going to talk about something really interesting called DevOps. What is it? Why is it essential in today's work culture? You'll be getting an entire idea as we proceed. But let us know what are we going to learn today. So first one is, what was the need of DevOps? What led to its birth? What is DevOps? Various phases it has. Then DevOps tools. Advantages of using it. How cloud complements DevOps. Various companies using DevOps. And finally, we'll be talking about the career growth it offers you. So let's get started. First of all, let us understand what led to the DevOps movement. And to know that, it is essential to learn what sort of difficulties came across while getting a software out in use. Development versus operations. Yes, development and operations are two different entities in an organization that never get along, though they ideally work in close coordination. You might often have heard about the frictions between the two teams due to this siloed mentality. Many times what worked on developer side failed when got on the operational floor, and hence the never-ending conflict arose. To operations, developers always build code that are oblivious to real-world constraints, and developers are under the impression that ops are resistant to change and hence becoming an obstacle to get a perfect product out. So they tend to lack a synchronization that affects and definitely delays the process of development and ultimately deployment. Another reason for this big delay is the traditional waterfall model most of the organizations operated on. Testing is done only after the entire code for a product is written, just like that, and every component of the process is dependent on each other. So how does it hamper the overall performance? Let us understand in this way. So let me give you an example for that. Suppose you have got four phases to develop a whole product. So now you have developed phase 1, then phase 2, phase 3, and finally phase 4 is also developed. And after the phases, it go for the testing. And testing team finds a bug in the phase 2 itself. That means all your efforts in coding phase 3 and phase 4 went in vain, since phase 2 itself was faulty and needed correction. So the logical building of phase 3 depended on phase 2 and so on, right? So what will happen? Again, you need to rework from phase 2, which killed your time, your efforts, and of course, delayed the process of product development. One of the major reasons of delays. And as a result of that, your productivity decreased because of the dependency on each other, and it increased the cost and timing required for the product to be up and running. So to address all these issues, to solve the conflicts between development and operations, DevOps was introduced. So what does it really mean? Let us go in detail. So it was introduced in year 2009. Let me tell you one thing, that it's not a tool, a software, or a language, but it is a culture, a philosophy, a change in mindset that encourages everything which is required to improve the way you do your business, to increase the productivity, lower the cost, and smoothen the process. DevOps requires a change in the mindset of how people work. In a DevOps environment, development and operations work in collaboration with each other and not against each other. It firmly believes in eliminating manual intervention, for it takes time, and automating the process and continuously integrating them. And most importantly, it works on agile methodology, means different phases of a product are developed and tested simultaneously and not sequentially. Since you now know and you have the knowledge of what is DevOps and which methodology it operates on, let us talk about the phases it incorporates. So, it majorly has got four phases. continuous development, that is continuous coding. Just like I told you that a software coding is divided into several phases to make the task easier. Continuous testing means whatever code is being generated is constantly being tested, and hence doing the testing in a few minutes or hours, which would otherwise might take days or weeks if done manually. And flaws are immediately detected if there's any and sent back to the coding team to rework. That means development and testing keeps on happening simultaneously and not sequentially as happened in waterfall model. Then it has got continuous integration. That is to say, whatever code is being generated or different versions of the same product is being saved in a local repository for future footprint. You can always review your work by using this continuous integration. And finally, development phase. So the coding is developed continuously and operated on the operational floor to check the efficiency of the product in real time. So these are the various and essential phases of DevOps to create a smooth environment for the organization. Now, as I said, that DevOps is not any technology or tool or a language, but a culture which emphasizes on using various tools, automation, close collaboration, synchronization, so as to help the organization, thus benefiting the complete software development to deployment process. So let's discuss some of these tools. Let's start it off with Jenkins. Yes, it's an important tool in DevOps culture. It is a tool which supports continuous testing of the code, continuous integration, and deployment of the code. Basically, it automates all the processes. Then we have got Ansible. Another tool used for application deployment and software provisioning. Using this tool, you can deploy your applications in n number of systems at one go. You don't really have to do it again and again, and hence saving the time. And then we have got Docker. It creates perfect environment for your applications to run. For example, if one application runs on, let's say, Windows and the other one requires iOS, so instead of having two different software codes, you simply have one Docker. Yes, and it would take care of all the requirements of your applications. Then we have got Puppet. It's a configuration management tool which enables system administrators to work faster and used for server provisioning. That is to say, it allocates the works to server and hence taking care of the management of your entire server infrastructures. Then we have got Chef. It is used for automation of infrastructure. With Chef, your infrastructure is defined as code, ensuring that configuration policy is flexible, versionable, testable, and human readable. It measures the load on the server and distributes it accordingly. Then we have got Nagios. It is a computer application that monitors system, network, and infrastructure. And what does it do? It alerts users if anything goes wrong, rectifies that, and again informs the user about the same. It also informs the user when any human intervention is required. And then we have got Git. It's a distributed version control system and one of the most important tools used in DevOps culture. And what does that mean? The distributed version control system means it is not dependent on any server. Even if your server fails, you'll be able to work. It maintains all the versions of your software with all the features. Like if you have written, let's say, 1.1 version of a software and then 1.2. So it'll keep all the versions. So anytime you can have a look on that and use accordingly. Also, it allows the users to work on different versions of software simultaneously. And finally, we have got Maven. It is very simple. It is used for compilation of source code and running tests. So these were a few of the tools used in DevOps culture shift to make your organization run smoothly and effectively. Finally, let us also talk about the advantages of using DevOps. First of all, it improves the collaboration between the two essential teams in the organization, development and operations. It encourages a change in the mindset to get the maximum profit out of your business. As a result, when people work with each other in collaboration, productivity definitely increases, and eventually it decreases the cost, which since you take less time in getting the product built. And finally, you maintain a good position in the market since your delivering rate of product is increased. And because of all of this, you have got happy and satisfied and smiling customers. You are all sorted. So let us now see how cloud complements DevOps. So now you know DevOps is a process to improve your way of doing business. And cloud connects and facilitates use of technology and services while taking care of provisioning of infrastructure. So cloud computing allows developers more control over their own components, resulting in smaller wait times. This application-specific infrastructure makes it quite easy for developers to own more components. And by using cloud tools and services to automate the process of building, managing, and provisioning through infrastructure as code, service teams speed the development process, eliminate human error, and establish accountability. And hence, cloud gives everything that is required for the DevOps to flourish. And finally, let's have a look which companies are following the DevOps culture. Many industries are already doing DevOps, like Amazon, Walmart, Visa, Sony Pictures, Adobe, Facebook, Netflix, to name just a few. And after all that, let us discuss the most important part, career opportunities DevOps has for you. As I said, it's not a technology that can be replaced by some other technologies. So any organization, if they want to grow big and work smoothly, they got to have DevOps in place. They don't have any other option. So employment for a DevOps expert is never a problem. As far as money is concerned, you'll be earning a handsome amount. In the United States, a certified DevOps professional can earn somewhere around $120,461 per year, according to Indeed.com, which is quite promising and quite, you know, astonishing as well. And after all this, you can get 360-degree knowledge about DevOps at Intellipaat with the best industry experts and witness your career grow. So these are the courses we here provide you at Intellipaat about the DevOps. Like, it's designed by industry professionals, then you'll get hands-on projects and case studies, self-paced training videos, instructor-led videos, and finally, Intellipaat DevOps certification. I hope this session has been informative and useful for you all. For any inquiry, contact Intellipaat anytime at the contact numbers and email ID being displayed. Thank you for your time. Have a good day.